Do you want to see something scary? I'm going to send my wife an email with a pretty dangerous link inside. There it is. Looks harmless, right? Let's see if she'll click it. So far, it looks harmless, totally a website she would visit. But what she doesn't know is that I now have control of her browser. I now know pretty much everything about her system. I can send her fake password prompts and then steal those passwords. And I can even redirect her to a website of my choosing. And even worse, this opens up the door for some serious attacks. And the scariest thing about this is that it's not that hard to do. The tool I'm using is called Beef.
I smell like beef.
And don't let the name fool you. This thing's crazy. In just a few seconds, you can spin up a fake website with malicious code baked in. And all you have to do is send a link to that fake website to your target. And if they just open that link in their browser, malicious JavaScript code will run. And it will hook their browser.
The hooks, me bucko. Beware the hooks.
Giving us control to do all kinds of crazy things.
They dangle down and draw you close. They grab you by the britches.
In this video, I have two goals. First, yeah, I'm gonna show you how to do this. And it doesn't take much. You'll have it up and running in 10 minutes. And second, I wanna show you how dangerous it is to open up any link that you don't recognize. And they may even look legit. They may have an SSL certificate. Doesn't matter, they can still be bad. So please, take this as a lesson for yourself and then tell everyone you know. Now, disclaimer, do not do this to anyone for any reason without explicit permission. This is
illegal.
Sure, trick your mom, your dad, your sister, your friend, your brother, whoever. Have fun with it. But that's it. Educational purposes only, for fun. If you try this with ill intent, you'll get caught and you'll probably go to jail. Because this is a real tool that real ethical hackers will use to test the security of companies that have hired them. So if that's not you, don't do it. Okay, first, what do you need to make this happen? Pretty much all you need is a Linux server, and preferably one in the cloud. And thanks to our sponsor, Linode, this is wicked easy to do and pretty dang cheap. And if you use my link below to set up a new account, you'll get $100 free credit for the first 60 days, which means you can basically do this for free. And don't worry, if this sounds like really intimidating, like I have no idea how to set up a Linux server, I'm gonna walk you through every single step. Now, of course, if you have something like Kali Linux or Ubuntu in your house, on your computer, whatever, that will work. Beef even comes pre-installed on most Kali Linux instances. That was hard to say. I can't do it. But you will have to do some port forwarding to make it work. If you don't know what that is, and it's kind of confusing, I do have some videos up here somewhere. But if you do it in the cloud with Linode, it'll work just like that. The second thing you need is a victim. Which is kind of the fun part. Again, friends, family, or it can just be your browser on your computer or another computer, or even, dude, you can do it on a phone, a phone's browser, which is scary. And then finally, like all things in IT and hacking, a good, delicious cup of coffee. NetworkChuck.com. Okay, step one, let's get our Linux server set up. So if you haven't already, head out to linode.com/networkchuck and either set up a new account or get signed in. And once you're there, let's click on create at the top left. And click on Linode, because we're creating a Linode. Now from here, things kind of get stupid easy. We're gonna go to the marketplace tab right here. It's gonna do all the work for us, check it out. And we're going to search for Beef. And it's right here. Using the marketplace, Beef will just come pre-installed on a server that we launch. We don't have to worry about it. So select that, and then we'll scroll down just a bit to add some settings for it, some config. Here, we'll have our Beef options, and the first thing we'll do is set up our Beef account user password. I don't know why I said it like that. So just put in something for yourself. And then just below that, put in an email address. This can be any email address. And really, I'm not sure it's used for this installation. It's just required, so you have to put something in there. Anyways, let's continue. Okay, next, and this is just good practice, best practice. We'll create a limited pseudo user to be created for the Linode. So just create whatever user account and then create a password for that user. Everything else is optional, but just pointing out here real quick, Linode will help you set up a domain for this so you can go a little bit crazy. But anyways, it'll do some cool stuff by default. So don't worry about that. So let's scroll down and do a few more things. First, our region, where are we gonna put this thing? Put it somewhere close to you. I'm in Dallas. Next, we'll select our Linode plan. I like my shared CPU because they're cheaper, and I'll choose the cheapest option. Linode 1 GB, $5 a month. So even if you're not getting this for free, that's as much as you're gonna be charged for this month. And then we're almost done. We have to label our box real quick. I'll name mine Attack Beef, and then a password from our root user. And that is pretty much it. We'll go ahead and click on Create Linode, and that sucker's gonna bake, and we're gonna take a quick coffee break. Now, one quick thing. You'll see at the top left, your Linode is baking, it's gonna be provisioning, and then it will finally get to running, but it's not quite done yet. We'll give it about 5 more minutes to finish installing Beef. So I'll take one more little coffee break. No harm in that, and I'll see you back here in a bit. Okay, I think it's baked long enough. Smell's done. So let's go ahead and grab this SSH root command right here. Just click on that little copy clipboard on the side. And then launch command prompt if you're in Windows, CMD, or if you're on Mac or Linux, it'll be your terminal. I'll paste that here, hit enter, accept all fingerprints, yes, and then put in my root password, the one we set when we set up our Linode, and we're in. Now past this point, it's remarkably easy to do this. It's honestly kind of scary, but let's keep moving. First, we gotta find out some information about our Beef server. So let's go ahead and do cat type in cat, and we're gonna cat the file /root/beef.info and hit enter. Perfect. If you see this, you know your beef installation was successful. If it wasn't, give it some more time. It's gotta bake some more. But right here, and this is what's cool about using Linode, we have a legit website URL, SSL, which is kind of crazy. So anyways, I'm gonna grab mine real quick. It's gonna copy that sucker, put it into a notepad for safekeeping. And also at this point, we can just go out to our web browser, paste in that URL, hit enter, and we're there. We have our beef server running. Linode made that super easy, I know. Now, if you're not using Linode, maybe using Ubuntu or Kali Linux, I'll have some more videos in the link below to help you get started with that and some documentation and walkthrough. So yeah, check that out. Anyways, we're here. Let's get logged in. The username will be beef. No big surprise there. And then the password you use when you set up Linode, and this is for your beef user, one of the first ones we did. So I'll enter mine and we're in. Okay, here we are. We have beef running. But now what? Well, let's hack someone right now. It's already set up. Check this out. Here in Beef, we have our getting started section, and you'll notice that we have two links right here, a basic demo page and an advanced page. We'll go ahead and use the advanced link, and this right here is a pre-built fake website that has malicious code. That's what's cool about Beef is we don't have to do much. It's already set up. So let's try it out. What do you say we hack ourselves real quick? So what I'm gonna do, go over here and copy this link. Right click, copy link address. And actually, before we do that, notice over here on the left, we have online browsers and offline browsers. These are browsers that we have hooks into. We caught us some fishes. I don't know if that's a thing. Anyways, so now with my link copied, I'm gonna open up a dummy computer, a dummy browser, open up Chrome, and here we go, sucker, here we go. Gonna paste that in the address bar and hit enter. Now, at first glance, this seems harmless enough, right? It's just a standard website where you might wanna buy some beef. But if we go back to our beef console, check this out. Would you look at that? Right here, we have a hooked browser. And it was as simple as that. Just using that demo website, having them load that up, bam, we have them. So now what can we do with it? Let's have fun. Come on, check this out. First thing we'll do is we'll just click this browser here, our online browser. Click it. And here under details, whoa, look at everything we know about this sucker. I mean, we know everything about it. Screen size, OS version. So that's powerful, but now let's click on commands. Let's actually do something. And it's so easy, it is scary. Watch, click on commands. Let's try something simple. I'm gonna click on the browser folder right here. Let's do a simple alert dialogue. I'll just type in, hey, you just got hacked. Now here we go. I'm gonna click on execute and watch what happens. Ah, look at that. A scary message. Hey, you just got hacked. Now, you may not want to let them know they just got hacked because you're trying to trick them, right? Let's try some more things. So I'll just go, oh, okay, I'm scared. What do you say we try some social engineering? So let's minimize our browser over here, our browser folder, click on social engineering. And this is kind of crazy, check this out. I'll do my favorite one, the Google phishing page. I'll click on execute at the bottom right and watch what happens. Whoa, suddenly no more beef. I'm on a different page. Looks like I need to log into Google. Let's go ahead and do that. Bernard.hackwell@gmail.com and my password and click on sign in. Now, this is weird. I don't know what this is. Let's close that. But I'll go back to the other page. It just took me to the Google sign in. And this is actually the legit Google sign in. But if I go back to beef, if I click on the history of that command, look at that. I have the username and password that my target entered. That's pretty crazy. Like, be honest. Would you fall for that? Maybe not. Would your mom fall for that? Your grandma, your sister? Probably, yeah. So please, use this as a chance to educate them after you mess with them. Show them how easy it is. Anyways, let's continue. Now, the scariest thing about this, right? Notice it did go offline because it's no longer on that domain. So it's now an offline connection. Let me get them back online. I'll go back to getting started, copy that link once more, and get them back home. Back to beef. There we go. Now they should be hooked again. Now, if you did this through a Linode, what's even more dangerous is it has an SSL cert already. Now, sure, this looks a bit weird because it's not a typical website, probably not the website you're going or you meant to go to. Let's try one more social engineering attack. This one's pretty cool, a fake LastPass, which could be very, very dangerous, access to pretty much all their passwords. If I click on execute on that, and I go back to my, oh, there it is. Look, it looks like LastPass, right? Get logged in, go. And like, it seems like you did something, right? And you don't seem like you got hacked, but man, on the back end, we got you. If I click on that command to see what happened, what's even crazy, check this out. It records each keystroke until we get to the end where we have the full information. So even if like they partially put it in, we got it all right here at the end. And what I meant is if they partially put it in, we'll still get something. Isn't that awesome? Man. And then I wanna show you one more thing before you start playing with this and going crazy. Check this out. Let's go over here to the network section, right here. I'll expand that folder. And here we can do some pretty crazy things like, I don't know, scanning their home network, finding out their IP addresses and what's going on inside. Let's try it out. So let's see, I've got some identify LAN subnets. Sure, why not? Let's run that. Execute. Now looking back at my hooked browser, I'm not gonna see anything going on. And in fact, Beef will tell you if one of the attacks here is going to be noticed. If I go back to the getting started page here, it has levels of noticeability for your attacks. So for, I'm colorblind, so forgive me if I say the colors incorrectly. Yellow will not be visible, so it's invisible. And green will actually, it may be visible, might not. So you got levels. Anyways, let's check on our attack here. I'll go back to my current browser tab, click on the details of that command, see what's happening. Scan complete, and I didn't find anything, and I know why. This particular host I'm connected to does not have a normal private IP address network. Although it did find these hosts. I don't know what that is. Let's try a ping sweep using Java, and I'll scan the subnet I know that's there, and let's start. And we'll monitor that from here, see what happens, and give it a second here. And it looks like it's having some issues, no worries. Let's try something else. Let's see how the HTTP servers on a certain subnet. I'll change that from common to a list. Shoot, let's also try to fingerprint the local network with this command. Let's do it all. Now I can get a live view of what's happening if I look at my logs up here. I'll click on that. I can see, yeah, it's checking a ton of stuff on each one of the IP addresses I put in that range. And finally, one last thing, we gotta leave them a going away present. So let's go up to our browser once more, or our browser folder, and we'll click the redirect browser, Rickroll. Let's try it out. Execute. Let's go see what happens. I love it every time it happens. And notice with this one, the URL did not change. So what happened is they set up an iframe on the page and nested this video or this website inside. And that's one way you can keep control of things while redirecting their browser. And there's a bunch of ways to do that. Like right here, redirect browser using an iframe. So I can direct them to networkchuck.com. Execute. Gonna make sure it went there. Bam. Look at that. And I still have control. I look really worried right there. What's wrong with me? Now it's time for you to have some fun and try this yourself. I cannot go over everything that's in this module tree here, all the tools that are available. It would just take too long. But I wanted to showcase some of the fun ones and to kind of like get you to think about what's possible. Like there are ways to add persistence to where when they do navigate away from that tab or close it or whatever, it'll still work. You can also integrate Beef with Metasploit and do even crazier things. But that's a video for another time. And by the way, did I mention that this works for mobile browsers too? Let me show you. Let me send this link to myself. And actually what I'll do to make it even more sneaky is just shorten the URL. So I'll just search short URL. There's a free one out there somewhere. Yeah, this one right here. I'll paste that address here, shorten it. So it doesn't look too crazy, not too fishy. Send that to myself, paste it in my browser, and let's get going. So yeah, that same Beef website, but if you look back at our Beef control panel here, we have a new device, an Apple device, an iPhone. Let's try one of our commands. Let's try to social engineer myself. Let's do a Google phishing attack. Execute, just like that. Mobile browser totally works. Enter in some data, blah, 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 blah. Doesn't have to be accurate. Click sign in, watch this, craziest thing ever. Redirects back to my Google account. I think I'm fine, but I actually just got my information stolen by my attacker. That's so crazy. Anyways, that's about it. Let me know what you think of Beef, the browser exploitation framework. I think it's a very valuable tool that you can learn to use if you are on the path of becoming a hacker, an ethical hacker, the only type of one you can actually be. It's also extremely helpful to demonstrate to your family that, and also friends, that they aren't necessarily safe online. In fact, they're not safe at all. So if you see a link, dude, don't open it if you don't know what it is. If it's not a URL that you recognize, don't go there. Because even if you don't think something's happening, you don't think you got a virus, behind the scenes, they could have hooked your browser. They could have hooked your family's browser and they're doing something behind, underneath your browser to your computer that you don't even realize. So anyways, that's all I have today. Thanks again to our sponsor, Linode, for making this video possible. And if you want to see more videos like this where I'm demonstrating these random hacking tools that I think are extremely interesting, let me know below, comment. And by the way, speaking of hacking, have you hacked the YouTube algorithm? Have you not? Make sure you do. Hit that like button, subscribe, notification bell, comment. You have to hack YouTube today. Ethically, of course. And for real, that's all I have. I'll catch you guys next time. Oh, almost forgot one thing. If you did not want to use Linode for Beef, I'll have some content down below to help you walk through installing that on a local machine in your network and even doing some port forwarding to make it work. But again, the easiest way to do it, just to get it up and running, is to use Linode. It won't cost you very much, if not anything, because it's gonna be free. If you are a new account and you have that code, you'll get $100 off for the first 60 days. Did I say it all right? I think I did. Anyways, like for real, I'll catch you guys next time.